Passing out 150 members of staff that have been undergoing a 3 weeks refresher training at Kawku, the National Water and Sewage Corporation Managing Director, Dr. Engineer Silver Mjisha, revealed that water theft remains a huge challenge to the corporation. Dr. Mjisha says police usually steal water, disguising to use it for fire extinguishing, but end up selling it to other Ugandans.
Unfortunately, we've got some elements of police with police vehicles getting water from our fire hydrants, purportedly to go and fight fire, but they go and deliver it in people's homes, on construction sites, on washing bays. And that's not very good. And that also happens with the elements of some UPDF officers. But fortunately, we have worked with the heads of these institutions. We have already alerted the IGP, and he has promised to help us. We are actually working with the director of fire brigade to see that these wrong elements can be punished.
We are very happy that we have partnered with National Water and Sewage Corporation in order to review our history and be able to map out the security of our future. Now, on the allegations that have been put forward on some of the errant officers, it has come out vividly that these are individual acts. They will be investigated, and those individual people found culpable will be brought to book.
The corporation loses 37% of its revenue to water thefts and illegal connections, and this, according to the corporation, is frustrating its efforts to progress. They are currently seeking to grow their assets from 3.8 to 6 trillion shillings, and this will be achieved through increased capacity building of staff, widening their coverage, among other interventions.
This training is not an indoctrination training that we are calling people to indoctrination. No. Instead, this training is about know your country and mindset. Is that a bad thing to do?
No.
Not a bad thing to do. This training is not a money-wasting exercise. I'm sure you have learned one or two things from here. Isn't it?
Yes.
So I want us to put this training in context. It's extremely, very, very important.
The training also instilled in the members of staff a spirit of patriotism, accountability, and mindset change. Story by Rachel Nachwala for the news.